On Meadow Gold Mondays, we have featured information on dairy trends and facts. We have also featured some of the community organizations that Meadow Gold has supported over the years, like AYSO and the Honolulu Zoo. Now, another nonprofit organization is the Children's Discovery Center, which has been serving our community here in Hawaii for a number of years. Today, we have Loretta Yajima, chair of the board of directors at the Children's Discovery Center. Loretta, hello. Thank you so much for being us.
Good morning.
You should have seen when she walked in, the first thing out of her mouth was, "You're not going to make me dance, are you?" And I didn't promise, Loretta.
I know, she didn't.
No guarantees. You never know what's going to happen on this show. All right, Loretta, tell us, how did the center get started?
Well, we are a private nonprofit organization, and we are so thrilled to have Meadow Gold as a partner. They are a wonderful partner and have been with us from the beginning. Yeah. And we started at Dole Cannery. Many people don't even know that we were the Hawaii Children's Museum at Dole Cannery Square.
I didn't know that.
Yes, oh. And we were so popular, we had to move to Kaka'ako to a larger site because we had so many school children and families that wanted to come. And we opened in the old city incinerator in 1998. But Trini, you know, we're the only children's museum in the world that opened in a pineapple cannery and ended up in a city incinerator.
Okay, that's a great trivia question for when we're playing Trivia Pursuit at home. What exactly is the mission of the center?
Well, we, you know, when I was asked to start a children's museum, I really looked at all the museums that are in the United States, and I realized that here in Hawaii, because we're an island state and the only island state, that we wanted to bring the world to the children of Hawaii, and we want to empower them, and we want to have them understand that learning can be fun. And so I think you'll see from some of the clips that we have here that children can really learn about themselves and the world through play. That's really important.
As you know, I have two small children, and I have spent many hours at the Discovery Center.
I'm so happy to hear that.
But it's a perfect place. You're right. It's like there's so many cultural aspects to it. It's fun. It's educational. It really is a great place to be. And when the weather is bad or when it's hot or if it's raining, it's a nice enclosed.
We are air conditioned.
Yes.
But, you know, you mentioned some of our cultural programming, and we have events all year long. And just on Sunday, we had our Keiki Bon dance. And so, you know, that we have taiko drumming, and the children learn to dance. And we also celebrate all the different ethnic and cultural celebrations in the center. It's really a wonderful place.
Now, I hear that our center here in Hawaii was actually was an inspiration for a center that opened up in China. Is that right?
You know, this is a little known fact, but about 3 years ago, almost 4 years ago, there was a group of Chinese businessmen that came to Hawaii on their way back to actually Inner Mongolia and China, of all places. And they came to visit the Children's Discovery Center. And all of a sudden, I got a call that evening, and they said they were so impressed and enthusiastic about the kinds of learning that can take place in a children's museum. They wanted to start the movement in China. And I'll never forget Mr. Niu, who heads this foundation in China, said, "I want to build 100 children's museums in 100 provinces in China. Will you help me?"
Wow.
And the first museum opened in Beijing on June 1st. And the second...
Last month.
Goodness. Yes. And already they have long lines going down the street and out the door. And it's really exciting.
So obviously there's a demand for this. There's a need for this.
You know, it was interesting when he approached me because he said, you know, this kind of early learning is really important for China because in a children's museum, it's an informal learning environment and children learn through play rather than rote memorization through books. But he was very impressed because as the children grow up, they use their imagination and creativity a lot more in the U.S. because of facilities like a museum.
Loretta, we're almost out of time, but I want to talk very quickly about the partnership with Meadow Gold. Now, through their assistance, what have you guys been able to do?
You know, what distinguishes Meadow Gold as a corporate partner is that they're absolute commitment to the community and the families that live here. We're so proud to have them as a partner, and we want to invite everyone to come down to our Wednesday and Friday Lonnie Moo and Kelsey show at the museum.
So every Wednesday and Friday, Lonnie Moo is there?
Lonnie and Kelsey are there. Yes.
Perfect. What time?
At 10 o'clock. 10 a.m. every Wednesday and Friday in the Imagination Station at the Children's Discovery Center.
All right, Loretta, thank you so much. Mm-hmm. You need to check them out. It's such a wonderful place.
Thank you.
Yes.